Sold out Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence as Phillips 66 presents Big 12 basketball. Today, the 7th-ranked Jayhawks are hosting the Horned Frogs of TCU. Now, KU playing today without Joel Embiid, their 7-foot center, is being rested today with a variety of injuries. Hi again, everyone. I'm Dave Armstrong, along with Chris Piper. And Chris, without Embiid today, what does that mean to KU?
7 foot of raw athleticism and power inside. And Joel Embiid was absolutely fantastic early against TCU. Dominated the paint inside, got them in foul trouble. They're going to miss his presence.
So we go from the post to the point. And when we look at our Sonic showdown, two of the better point guards in this conference.
Well, two really active point guards. Kian Anderson for TCU. He's a guy that can score some points. 22 points a game average in February alone. And Nabeer Tharp, he's just really been doing whatever Kansas needs. Was scoreless against TCU the first time, but he had coming off a double-double against Kansas State. And Kian Anderson, you know, he struggled against Kansas, but his ability to put the ball down the floor really hurt KU the first time. 8 of 8 from the free throw line. And Nabeer Tharp, what Bill Self was looking for him is consistency. He does all the little things for Kansas, but you just don't know what game he's going to step out and have the big presence for you. They need more consistency from Nabeer Tharp.
Let's see who joins Tharp in that starting five for KU. A couple of freshmen in Wayne Selden and Andrew Wiggins, a couple of special freshmen, then Perry Ellis, the sophomore, and Tarik Black is taking the place of another freshman, Joel Embiid. As far as the Horned Frogs are concerned, Anderson is joined in the backcourt by a freshman in Brandon Parrish. Amrick Fields, good-looking player, junior, banged up with a knee, but playing really well his junior campaign. Jarvis Ray and Kavar Shepherd, who almost chose KU ahead of TCU, but decided to play for Trent Johnson instead. Trent Johnson, in his second year, he knows he is not playing with a full deck in terms of the fact that 5 of their players are out for the season with injuries, and he knows that next year is when he's really going to start making a push.
Well, how do you get your team ready to come into the number 7 ranked team's home floor after they got beat at home by 20-plus? It's a character game for TCU, a building block game. See if they can maintain their composure.
The opening tip goes to the Jayhawks, who are clad in their home jerseys, and Selden tries to go in strong, and Shepherd comes over with a foul.
Foul trouble early in the game down in Fort Worth was what hurt TCU. Kavar Shepherd and Jarvis Ray sitting on the bench for the bulk of the minutes in the first half, and Kansas immediately attacking. TCU not doing a good job of matching up out that jump ball.
There's Selden, a McDonald's All-American freshman, averaging 10 points a game, a 62% free throw shooter. Should be better than that.
Yeah, he's a better shooter. He kind of gets stuck in some streaks where he misses them at the free throw line. One compounds itself to another.
There's Tarik Black as it's slapped away by Ray, but it goes off of Ray, and it will stay with KU. A lot's happened in 8 seconds, and nothing's happened.
Now, Tarik Black already providing a presence inside to make up for Joel Embiid not being there. TCU, not a very good rebounding team. That's putting it lightly. Minus 15 in conference play.
Tharp tries a three. That's off the heel, no good. And there's Kian Anderson with a rebound.
Against Kansas the first time was off the bounce, getting into the paint. Really didn't have very many open outside looks.
Like there, off the bounce, and he draws the contact. We'll send him to the line.
And I think that's what you got to do against Kansas. You got to put the ball down, attack them, get to the paint, see if you can force help. One of the problems I think Kansas has had defensively this season has been late help defense.
Anderson averaging 22 and a half points a game in his last 4 for the season, 16 a game.
He's been tremendous. I think 29 points coming off that Baylor game, which was probably TCU's worst game of the year.
Yeah. And he puts TCU in a lead with a couple of free throws.
2-3 zone by TCU. Kansas was effective hitting shots against it early down in Fort Worth. Kansas is going to run their man-to-man offense early. A little pick, and now the screen down low.
Great penetration.
Nice job.
Dear Tharp.
Nice job, I thought, finding a hole in the defense, bringing up that middle interior defender and dropping it off down low.
Going back to half court. Almost over and back. Wiggins with the steal. Seldon loses the handle. Black. Counted and one.
Attacking the basket is what Kansas does so well. Watching Deerthorpe find the seam in the defense. Kavar Shepherd coming up really soft defensively. And how about the big man, Tarik Black, the senior. A nice spin move to split defenders there. Had Wiggins on the wing. They were worried about that, but instead able to split and get through the middle.
Not unusual for Black to start. He had done that at the first portion of the season, and then about halfway through, Embiid took over. Now Embiid not playing today.
You know, but that shows a senior composure for Tarik Black not to get down on himself. When Embiid kind of stepped in there, Tarik Black started off the season slowly. Now he's hung around, and he's getting his chance again.
Drive to the basket by Jarvis Ray, and he draws the contact. Foul there is on Tarik Black. Two team fouls now on KU, the first on Black. Jarvis Ray is a guy as a senior. There are times where he disappears for the Horned Frogs. Missed most of last year. Coming back this year, he started all 23 games, Ray.
Well, he struggled to finish inside against Kansas down in Fort Worth. And you know, he has the ability to slash from the wing. I like TCU's mentality so far, and that's attacking the paint. You get yourself hurt here at the Fieldhouse. You come in and you try to rely on outside jumpers early. If you're not hitting them, you can find yourself down in a hurry.
Whistling a foul inside, trying to set a pick. And this is on Tarik Black, so we're going to already see Jamari Traylor check in as Black. This was his problem early in the season. He would pick up two quick fouls, and he's done it again here today.
Yeah, physical presence inside. That time, the double stack offense for Kansas. The big man takes out the middle. Just can't walk him up the lane. That's what they called it for.
Shepherd pulls up for the jumper, and he's got it.
I think you got to get out, get a little further out, more presence. Shepherd can hit that face-up jumper from the perimeter. Jamari Traylor, you got the speed. Get out there and get in his face. Nice recognition by Shepherd to shoot over the top.
Andrew Wiggins pulls up.
Well, Wiggins didn't have too bad of a game against TCU down in Fort Worth. 19 in the first half, and those type of plays.
27 for the game. Parrish, off-balance shot. Almost a walk by Seldon.
Yeah. Mark Whitehead got in his way there. I think let him get away with it. Official down underneath. He's still trying to get down there.
Penetration creates a three-point attempt. No. Traylor. The shot was blocked. The foul came, which will send Traylor to the line to shoot two.
You know, Jamari Traylor is such an active presence for Kansas. Watch where he starts on this play and how he fights through three TCU defenders, not one of them thinking about boxing him out. And that's what's put this TCU team in a bad position. Minus 15 in conference play on the glass. And Jamari Traylor providing that energy, starting mid-block, getting all the way to the glass through three defenders.
Chris, he doesn't play as many minutes, but he reminds me in the way he rebounds of a Melvin Edgem or a Dustin Hogue of Iowa State.
You know, what he reminds me of is, those guys attack and they get right after you. And that's what Jamari Traylor does. He's an energy guy, comes off the bench, and gets right after it.
With the line today, the Jayhawks haven't hit one yet. They are 0 for 4 from the free throw stripe. And looking inside and finally tapped home. That's the game plan of the Horned Frogs today, is taking it into the paint.
Now get it in the paint. See if Kansas can be able to defend it.
For Kansas State really exposed KU in the second half the other night in Manhattan.
Yeah, they did it. Kansas State outworked Kansas in that game Monday night.
Three-point shot is off, no good. Fields skies for the rebound. Surprised he didn't take that. Instead, he finds Parrish for three in the corner.
A nice presence by TCU on the offensive end, taking the shots that are there.
Barry Ellis gets his own rebound.
Emmerich Fields trying not to foul in that situation. Make Kansas score over the top. Don't put them at the free throw line because this TCU team is really thin. Definitely inside.
Ray turns the corner. Boy, when Jarvis Ray starts hitting some buckets for you, that's a great sign for the Horned Frogs.
Like the recognition by TCU. Not forcing anything necessarily. They're just taking open shots.
And a turnover on an interior pass. So Brandon Parrish and the Horned Frogs have quieted the crowd here at Allen Fieldhouse. And we're back after this message from our friends at Phillips 66. And it's brought to you by Phillips 66. Proud to be here. By Whataburger. Swing by Whataburger today to pick up the newest all-time favorite, the Monterey Melt. By Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's. And by Motel 6, the official economy lodging partner of Big 12 fans everywhere. Now walking the halls of the booth, Hall of Athletics. Museums here attached to Allen Fieldhouse. And right now it's TCU surprising this hometown crowd. And boy, did they surprise the Jayhawks a year ago. This was in Fort Worth. Nadir Tharp with a miss. Or with a shot here, but look at Garland Green comes in with the basket. And then Garland Green again with the drive and the floater. That goes. And Nate Butler-Lynn with a putback jam, and TCU celebrates. And that was the infamous post-game tirade by Coach Self. I would call it a tirade, but his comments about how not since the days of James Naismith and the Topeka YMCA has Kansas looked so bad.
Yeah, he's a history buff, but I'm not sure he actually knew that for sure.
Jarvis Ray again. Boy, showing some great athleticism.
A great finish by Jarvis Ray. Kansas full court pressure. Got the steal on the first one, but gave up the layup on the second one. You know, that game last year was really a hangover effect, I think, from the Oklahoma State loss at home. And Bill Self kind of talked about how he maybe learned something from that game as well. You got to let him go, and they just hung on and kept that one, and that turned into a three-game losing streak for Kansas. And
one of the things he was talking to us about at practice yesterday, the loss in overtime to Kansas State on Monday, doesn't want one to turn into two. Three-pointer is off, no good. Kansas can't control the rebound.
Got two Kansas players on that one. Neither one comes up with it.
Now Fields, a three-pointer. Emmerich Fields, 36% three-point shooter, and it's a five-point TCU lead, their biggest lead of the game.
You know, it's amazing how making shots makes all the difference in the world, doesn't it?
Off the hands of Landon Lucas.
Atlanta Lucas got to go get that with two hands.
And a timeout taken by Coach Self, not happy at all about the energy of his team right now.
Well, poor effort defensively. TCU doing a great job shooting the ball, and that's primarily because they're getting open shots. Simple plays, loose balls, the 50-50s. Bill Self probably not happy with that. Rebounding. TCU winning that battle. And how about Kansas? You kind of get an idea of how a team comes out focus-wise by looking at free throws. Kansas 0-for-5 from the free throw line to start this game.
And 0-for-3 from three-point land, where, as you said, with TCU, when you hit shots, you look so much better. They're 2-for-2 from three-point land.
You know, you look back at that game at Fort Worth, and Joel Embiid made such a huge impact in that game early. The ball went inside to him every single time for over the first 10 possessions. seconds. And when the ball went inside for TCU on the other end, Joel Embiid was there blocking shots. So you get them in foul, you get TCU in foul trouble on one end, and you're blocking their shots on the other. Embiid made a huge, huge presence. And obviously, he's not going to be able to make a presence here except for as a cheerleader.
Christian Gore driving in, and he is fouled on the play. Foul here is on Mason, his first. That's the fourth team foul on KU this half. I saw that graphic recently, Chris, of they're showing Bill Self's home record, and I'm always amazed every time they show that. 171-9 now, which means as many home losses as Big 12 titles, nine straight. And a five-second call here against the Horned Frogs.
Nine losses in itself is an amazing feat, but nine straight Big 12 championships, that's over the top.
And in first place right now, game lead over Texas.
Triple team down in the post.
And able to steal it away, Jarvis Ray.
Got to be strong, rip that ball down, you hold it above your head, defender's going to get it.
Mason ahead of the pack.
So fast. Wise decision by Perry Ellis coming up with that steal to give it to Frank Mason. He's got another gear he can kick it into.
Anderson and one. The second foul on Mason.
Again, where's it happening for TCU, Dave? In the paint. Every single time they're driving. And if they don't end up with the shot inside, it's because they've driven and been able to open it up from the outside. No help rotation by Kansas. This Kansas team is not a typical Bill Self defensive team.
Yeah, in years past,
they've had glimpses of it, but they haven't been able to sustain it.
Now a six-point lead for the Horned Frogs. You're right. I mean, normally, field goal percentage defense is around 35 to 38%. This year, over 40% as Perry Ellis gets inside.
It's a young team, and it takes a while for new guys in the system to understand what they have to do defensively. But like Bill Self says, nobody's a freshman anymore at this stage of the year. Running out of weeks to get yourself ready for tournament time.
Anderson pulls up. Anderson starting to heat up. And by the way, the Horned Frogs are sizzling. 8 for 11 from the field.
Not taking many contested shots. That's the difference.
Selden wide open for a three. That won't go. Oh, there's Lucas. He can't finish. And a whistle and a foul on TCU. So we've got a break with 11:34 to go. The Horned Frogs with a six-point advantage over the seventh-ranked Jayhawks.
6, a wild finish in Stillwater. All tied, closing in on a minute to play. Buddy Hield had just hit a three to tie it, and then no defense. He hits the three to put them up. They never trailed again. Oklahoma State loses their sixth in a row, 77-74. David Pipes, what do you think?
Thanks, Doug. Boy, Oklahoma State now drops to 4-8 in league play, and Oklahoma now 8-5. Here, TCU surprising the seventh-ranked Jayhawks, 22-16. Ian Anderson has been as advertised, 7 points so far. Emmerich Fields has chipped in 5. Really, the story has been how hot the Horned Frogs are, 8-11 in this game so far. So here is Landon Lucas going to the line.
Landon Lucas can be expected to have a lot of minutes for Kansas this afternoon, especially with Joel Embiid sitting out the game and Tarik Black with 2 fouls already. So they need a big production out of Landon Lucas. Embiid has not practiced since the Kansas State game Monday. He spent all week rehabbing that knee and back. Bill Self hoping to get him back tomorrow, possibly.
You hear the big cheer from the crowd because that's the first free throw that the Jayhawks have made in this game. They were 0 for 6 until that one went down. Here's Price, blocked by Lucas.
Yeah, great job by Landon Lucas coming over from the weak side to help. This was a bad closeout by Perry Ellis, over pursued, but Landon Lucas coming, avoiding the contact. Nice job.
And you look at Embiid just sitting there watching Landon Lucas. I love Lucas's attitude, along with, you talked about it earlier with Tarik Black, the fact that they know that Joel Embiid is that rising star, and Lucas, who is a redshirt freshman, redshirt last year, and yet he defers to a guy like Joel Embiid, saying, look, it's our job to make him as good as he can be.
Well, they work him, too, and you don't put your head down. You keep fighting in practice.
The alley-oop that almost went awry, but Wiggins made it work.
And Brandon Parrish recognized it on the weak side, tried to get over there and stop it, but the athleticism of Wiggins just able to get in there. That was a play that Kansas ran extremely effectively down at Fort Worth. Numerous times, backside lobs, and I'm sure that Trent Johnson did a great job this week at talking about that.
Anderson, a big three-pointer.
Three-point basket by Keon Anderson.
High ball screen, gets him open. He is picking right up off the Baylor game. Shooting the ball effectively from the outside, attacking the basket as well.
He's 3 for 3 in the game and 10 points. Selden pulls up.
Nice inbound offense by Kansas. A lob pass to the block, the kick out to the wing, and the extra pass by Connor Frankham.
I like the crispness of his passes, Frankham.
Frankham good on the offensive end for Kansas. He's just got to figure out this defensive end.
Gore drives in. No foul called, and Wiggins. Ellis, a three-pointer. Wow!
Ellis, first three of conference season. Trent Johnson unhappy with the officials right now. Felt like that drive should have been called. A little physical out there. We're letting them play, and there's the trailer. Perry Ellis. Hitting a guarded three at that, but got it in motion. Playing with a little energy right now. Kansas on the defensive end. It'll be interesting to see if the officials start calling a little bit tighter here in the next few minutes.
First three hit by the Jayhawks. Only the fourth three hit by Ellis all season. We invite you to play basketball at Phillips 66. A chance to win prizes instantly and shoot for $66,000. Phillips 66, proud to be here.
Well, I guess, Dave, you can look at it from one way from Kansas. If you start out the game 1 for 5 from three and 1 for 7 from the free throw line, I guess you can't be too upset you're down by one.
Right, that's
and,
true.
And you're giving up, what, 60, 70%
yeah.
somewhere in that range
yeah.
shooting-wise? Will Self got a smile on his face right now, but I'm sure he's not real thrilled with the defensive effort. But effort-wise for Kansas, they've turned it up a notch here in the last possession.
And some full-court pressure. An 8-3 run for the Jayhawks to pull back within one. Here comes Parrish. Fields open for three. Ellis was all by his lonesome for the rebound and then fouled from behind. That'll be the fifth team foul on the Horned Frogs.
15th on TCU.
Foul there is called on Hudson Price, his first.
Zone by TCU.
Ellis. First time the Jayhawks have led since the very early moments of this game.
Nice set play by Kansas coming down against that 2-3.
Wiggins just took that away from Gore. Selden. And a whistle and a foul on Perry Ellis fighting for that rebound.
You know, you watch Andrew Wiggins, and he's the type of guy that I don't think will ever get full credit for how hard he plays because he makes it all look so easy. Christian Gore went up early for that rebound. Had it. Andrew Wiggins comes in about a half second later, which is a lot in basketball, and is able to go through him and get that rebound. With that explosiveness and the ability to just jump so fast.
Is it the expectations were too high almost coming in for Wiggins, and it's impossible for anybody to live up to that?
I think he's lived up to them.
I mean,
he's going to set a freshman record for scoring. Yeah. People are like, well, we want more. But he's that type of player. He just shows you that his upside is just unlimited.
Then McLemore had the freshman record just a year ago at 15.9. Wiggins has outscored him, and of course, both of them ahead of Danny Manning, who you played with, who averaged 14.6 as a freshman.
Yeah, it took a long time to break that record of Danny Manning, and Ben McLemore does it last year. And Andrew Wiggins most likely going to get it this year. That's good ball movement that time by TCU on the offensive end. Getting it side to side, attacking the middle. Nice job by Amber Fields getting inside.
And I can't really give TCU any more credit than the fact that here they are at 0-11 in league play. They've lost a ton of players. And in fact, only four have suited up for every game this year. They have gone through more injuries than I can ever remember any team. And yet here they are at 0-11 playing on the road, coming off a 20-some point loss. And they are playing with great passion and energy.
Yeah, that's huge testimony to Trent Johnson and his coaching to be able to get these guys to come out and battle, not have their heads down. Big thing, though, will be if they can sustain it as well. You know Kansas is going to make runs at you.
Good find by Ellis.
Good low-high action that time. Short corner, Perry Ellis. Jamari Traylor diving from the top. Shots come a little tougher for TCU now. Kansas has turned up that defensive intensity a little bit.
Variety of moves from Anderson. His shot goes off the heel. Chris, if there's any knock on Kian Anderson, it would be that every now and then the ball sticks in his hands.
Yeah, and that last possession, it didn't move much, and that's why he ends up with a tougher shot.
Woo! What a floater by Andrew Wiggins.
Patience that time by Kansas. You don't always have to attack it the first time you touch it. You don't always have to take the first open shot you touch against the zone.
Jayhawks lead the conference in points in the paint, doing it here today. Anderson blocked, but they'll call that offensive goaltending. So count the basket for Kian Anderson. He's got a dozen, and it's a two-point contest. But the interior passing of the Jayhawks, almost too much for the Horned Frogs to handle. Kansas with a two-point lead. We're back after this from our friends at Phillips 66. Jayhawks have gone on a bit of a run here to take a two-point lead. And meanwhile, TCU cooling off a little bit, just one for their last five. Chris, what's KU doing defensively to cause problems to the Horned Frogs?
Well, Kansas struggled against the ball screen at times this year, but watch Jamari Traylor on here. He's going to get him to go away from the basket up high instead of being able to turn the corner. He doesn't get into the lane. And so now, Kian Anderson's got to make something happen on his own. Where Kansas has struggled here this afternoon is when, off that ball screen, Kian Anderson able to get into the paint directly off the ball screen rather than going away. So a nice hard hedge that time by Jamari Traylor makes him change directions to go away from the basket.
Selden driving the net. Against that zone, gets his own rebound and sinks it back in.
He is so strong to the basket. Rarely ever see him miss the initial on that. They show him that strength, those broad shoulders, able to go up, clear space, and get the finish. Kansas overplaying at the high post. They do not want Amrick Fields to catch it at the high post. That disrupts the TCU's action.
Switch out top. Now Frankham guarding Anderson. Short corner. Shot is short for Amrick Fields.
Nice recognition, though, by Kian Anderson. Feeling the help come from Jamari Traylor. Hits Fields. He's just not able to hit the jump.
And a blocking foul inside. It'll be team foul number 6 on TCU, and this one on Amrick Fields. Hey, today's game brought to you by Puerto Rico Tourism Company. Live your own star vacation story. Puerto Rico, the all-star island. Visit seepuertorico.com.
No snow there, is there?
No. They keep promising warmer weather, but we haven't seen it yet. Selden. Selden had that run where he hit 24 against Oklahoma. It up with another 20-point effort. Kind of slacked off. It was almost non-existent on Monday against K
State.
Yeah, that was a game that he ended up sitting the remaining part of the game on the bench, and that's usually not a good sign from the coach.
He's got six today. Four, because he was in the land of the Giants, decided to give it up. I don't think Fields was expecting that.
Well, it was where the pass ended up, though. Mm-hmm. It was at his feet. Kansas team has not had problems scoring this season. Their problem has been stopping teams. Now the six-point lead that Kansas has built has been because they've been able to stop TCU here the last few possessions.
Good block by Price.
Now, nowhere to go for Perry Ellis underneath there. He needed to kick that out. Great job by Hudson Price with the ball fake, getting Jamari Traylor up in the air.
We learned that from his dad, Mark, of course. Mark Price, a great player from Georgia Tech, star in the NBA for many, many years. Hudson Price, a freshman from Orlando.
At the line, Hudson Price, shooting two.
That's Jamari Traylor, big mistake there. That's a play you wait for him to release the ball and then go get it. Raiders athleticism.
Giving Perry Ellis a breather. Good play at both ends for Price. A block at one end and a ball fake at the other. Brandkamp for three. No. Price for the rebound. Anderson trying to push. Would have found it had it gone. Anderson would go to the line.
Great job by Keenan Anderson pushing the transition, going right at Kansas. Kansas not sorting in transition very well defensively, just coming right down the floor at you. Yeah, Jamari Traylor gets in the way of Connor Francamp. You got to stop the ball, guys. Get in there and stop it. And Anderson picking up where he left off last game against Kansas as well. Transition buckets pushing the ball down the floor.
Doing even better, actually. He's already got 13 points in this game with four assists. So he has 13 in this game, and the rest of the team, 16 more.
And Trent Johnson's got to be really happy. They're sticking around, down by three, a chance to get up to two, and they've got two of their starter big men sitting on the bench. Shepard and Ray, both with two fouls each. That was the same story down in Fort Worth. Both those guys were foul-troubled first half as well. It's a small lineup on the floor right now for TCU. Amrick Fields playing the center spot.
Lucas, triple team down low. Seldon a pull up, two more. That looks smooth.
Good balance by Wayne Seldon. Starts to look inside at the top. Gets cut off there, switches, crossover low. Defense there, but they're slacking off. Pull up for the jump.
Anderson pulls up again. Boy, he almost can't miss. He's 5 for 6 from the field.
It's almost to the point you're going to have to run a double team at the guard. Huh. Well, team double team big men down low, but Kansas and Deer Thart not able to slow down Keenan Anderson.
16 for Anderson. Now Seldon a three. Flat footed three, but he goes.
Take it. Well, it was Andrew Wiggins down at the TCU. Here up in Lawrence, it's Wayne Seldon showing the first half.
He's got 11.
Big as he is, hedging up there effectively on the ball screen.
Williams, nothing there. Back to Anderson.
And four low, and set the high ball screen. See if they can keep him out of the paint.
Shot clock at two, and he loses the handle. Seldon trying to fire a pass to Wiggins off his fingertips and out of bounds. So with 2:42 remaining in the half, Seldon said, that was my bad. As they come over to the huddle, a 5-point Jayhawk lead.
66 halftime report. Paul Biancardi in studio will break down the first half of action in Lawrence. Also a bedlam finish. It was wild. Top 25 scores and highlights. Dave and Pipes, we'll talk to you in just a couple of minutes.
Doug. Well, here it's TCU. They had an early lead. Kansas went on a bit of a run, but the Horned Frogs are staying certainly within striking distance. It's a five-point contest right now. Trent Johnson and his Horned Frogs, led by Kian Anderson, who's just been special. 16 points for Anderson in this game. He has almost half of the Horned Frog points. Amrick Fields has also chipped in a half dozen. Now, meanwhile, for the Jayhawks, playing without Joel Embiid today, he's out with a variety of injuries. And then Tarik Black got two fouls in the first 2 minutes of this contest. Anderson with the ball, trailing by five.
Well, really a Big 12 play for TCU. It has been Kian Anderson and Amrick Fields as far as the offensive scoring.
Well, it sure has.
And again, with Shepard sitting on the bench, Ray sitting on the bench, those guys have to carry the load.
In fact, in Big 12 play, Anderson and Fields have accounted for 50% of the scoring for the Horned Frogs this year.
Here's Tharp picking up his second foul.
And now Williams will go to the line. Michael Williams, a freshman from San Antonio.
That's not a good foul for Tharp. Fouling Williams that far from the basket. You want to have pressure, but with today's rules, you have to understand what that pressure is that far out on the perimeter. Especially not for the second foul for Nadir Tharp.
And remember, Mason, who's sitting next to him on the bench, has two fouls himself. Connor Francamp will run the point. Frank Mason sitting with two fouls. Nadir Tharp sitting with two fouls. Tarik Black with two fouls. The keys to the Jayhawk offense, especially against the zone, is to swing the ball side to side. Make that defense move.
Well, that's a key to all Bill Self offense. He always wants second side, third side. Move that defense.
Air ball thrown up by Parrish.
A few bad shots, really, by TCU here this afternoon. Great look inside, Wayne Selden.
Locust with it. Selden with the find.
Landon Lucas is so big inside. We were playing against Jeff Whitney last year. Taught him how to get space. Great hustle, TCU coming up loose ball again.
Three-pointer goes for Kian Anderson. My goodness, 19 first-half points.
And heads-up play by Christian Gore to come up with the loose ball and immediately know where Anderson is on the floor and hit him. Kansas now out of sorts defensively after not getting the loose ball and a good recognition.
Francamp for three.
Francamp started off the season struggling from three.
Around shot by Anderson, showing the full arsenal today. He's got 21.
Now Francamp, 6 of 12. Big 12 play from three, but Kian Anderson just too much for Kansas right now. Early transition opportunity. Don't let that Kansas defense get set up. Anderson going to full 20 this half as well.
TCU shooting 56% from the field. Kansas shooting 62%.
Offensive game. The way Bill Self wants it to be.
Wiggins a three. And now he's got 11. This is the biggest lead of the game for the Jayhawks. And that's a carry.
Well, you're going to make mistakes when you got the ball in your hands all the time. Kian Anderson, get over that one quickly. Landon Lucas, a nice show on the ball screen. Kansas less than two. See if they get some.
It'll count if it goes. Boy, it was right on target, just a hair short. Well, TCU is trailing by seven, but Kian Anderson, as he goes off into the locker room, what a half. 7 for 8, hits all of his free throws, 21 first half points. Man, what an effort. But it's the Jayhawks who lead it, 47-40. And now let's get you to Doug Bell in Studio 66.
Dave, thanks so much. Welcome, everyone, inside Studio 66. Doug Bell and Paul Biancardi. TCU hanging in there. The fact that Embiid is not playing major factor, do you believe?
Yeah, that's why TCU got off to a good start. Look, they drove the ball into the paint. That was the game plan for Trent Johnson. No shot blocker in the game for Kansas. They started off well, but Kansas started to figure out that zone, did a good job of attacking the short corner, the high post. They made some shots. Seldon, Ellis, and Wiggins all have 11 points. Kansas, we know, can score the ball. And I love their defense, Doug. They really force you out. And TCU's having a hard time, except for that guy by the name of Anderson.
Yeah, he's pretty good and has been all season long. All right, let's get you up to date. What else is happening? Earlier today, right here on the Big 12 Network, Texas Tech against Iowa State. And at one point, Cyclones led by 18. And then look out, Fred Hoiberg, the mayor, knew this was going to be a tough one, just the way the Red Raiders have been playing. There's the steal and Melvin Edge. And look out, Paul. Oh.
Iowa State, number one in the Big 12 in steals and number one in the Big 12 an assist. They had 20 assists on 27 field goals, Doug. That's remarkable.
Yeah, that was Jay Crockett inside, and then Jordan Tolbert misses. Edgem gets the rebound, and there's Georges Niang. You call him Georges, right?
Yeah, Georges from New England. Can't jump over a phone book, but boy, can he score the basketball.
Yeah, nice win for Iowa State, bouncing back after that shellacking in Morgantown. All right, Bedlam 2 in Stillwater, and this was the one they'll be talking about a long time. Yeah, the Cowboys felt good even with Marcus Smart sitting out a second game. Phil Forte to Brian Williams. And Williams elevates.
Well, Oklahoma State come out really strong to start the game. Second half, they come out an 11-2 start. They were ready to play this game.
Buddy Hield hit 2 3-pointers in a row. That one, the defense was non-existent. And then Markell Brown gets a decent look.
Got a great look. Wide left, as they say in football.
Yep.
But Buddy Hield, where was the defense on Buddy Hield? That's what I want to know.
Ooh, look at this. 6 losses in a row for the Cowboys. Joe Lunardi still has them in his field, NCAA field, but they're teetering right now, Coach.
Well, I think he's expecting when Marcus Smart comes back, they're going to start to win. It's just not going to be that easy. There's a timing and a rhythm when you bring a player back. Oklahoma State right now, uncertainty is in that locker room.
Yeah, no question about it. Coming up a little bit later on, we'll be watching some of the other games. Kansas State Baylor, that's on ESPNU, 6 o'clock Central. And then the Longhorn Network, 7 Central, West Virginia at Texas. Important games. Big 12, every game's big.
Yeah, two great guards, Juwan Staten for West Virginia and Isaiah Taylor for Texas. Two underrated point guards out of high school, two of the best point guards in the Big 12.
Yeah, no question. Kean Anderson, you mentioned him, Coach, off the top. And he's only 7 of 8 from the field. He's a nifty guy, just hanging around. Why not? 7-point game in the fog. 12 Network game is brought to you by Phillips 66. Proud to be here. Your Phillips 66 player of the week is Iowa State's Melvin Edgem. He posted double-doubles in both games last week, including setting a Big 12 record with 48 points against TCU. Shot 83%. Also grabbed 18 rebounds in that phenomenal performance right here in the Big 12 Network. Hey, Roy, what are you doing? He's going to hurt his shoulder throwing those shirts into the seats. Check this out. Oh, big dunk by J.P. Tokoto, huh?
That's where North Carolina's best.
Yeah.
Fast break points. They had 14 today.
And here comes Pitt on the other end. Lamar Patterson counted in the foul. They made a 10-2 run. They were down by only 4 at that point. And in the end, James Michael McAdoo, big shot, Coach.
Yeah, big day for McAdoo, 24-12. Marcus Page went 5-for-6 behind the three-point line.
Yeah, first time they've played since 96. Back after this from your friends at Phillips 66. This week's Classroom Champion is brought to you by none other than Phillips 66. Proud to be here. And how about Tariq Black, who we saw playing in our game today. Senior in graduate studies, a 3.25 GPA, Dean's List 6 times. Congrats to Tariq Black. Hey, don't forget to sign up for the Fun Run. That's in Kansas City, Saturday morning prior to the championship game. And all the guys, Dave Armstrong and Reed Geddes and Brendan Manzer, I can't commit. The rest of them will be running on Saturday morning. Perry Ellis, Coach, good first half for Ellis. Much needed, too.
Yeah, missed the consistency for Kansas. 5-for-7 from the field, 1-for-1 from threes, 3 assists, 11 points. Jayhawks up at home.
Pong at Phillips 66 for a chance to win prizes instantly and shoot for $66,000. Phillips 66, proud to be here. Coach, what about Wayne Seldon?
The power guard from Boston, Massachusetts. 11 points, 4 assists. Jayhawks up 7.
Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, where the Jayhawks enjoy a 7-point lead at the half, 47-40. With Chris Piper, I'm Dave Armstrong. And Chris, that was the first half that was an offensive show for both of these teams. As we look at our Shelter Insurance first half highlights, it was an offensive show.
It was a Kian Anderson show, really. 21 points. How about this line? 7 of 8 overall, 2 of 2 from 3, 5 of 5 from the free throw line. Step back moves, pull up, crossovers. Nothing that Kansas did defensively against him could stop him. Perry Ellis, a great first half as well, finding some work down in the short corner, using that right shoulder to get him off and then get the put back. And how about the little low-high action? Go to the short corner, big man drops. Jamari Farrell there with a catch and finish. And Wayden Selden, a nice first half as well. 11 points. He was effective, especially late, finding jumpers on the outside.
Well, where it was the Kian Anderson show for the Horned Frogs in the first half, three guys with 11 points each for the Jayhawks, Selden, Wiggins, and Ellis. Here's our first half numbers brought to you by Papa John's. And I don't think I've seen a half where one team's over 60% and the other one's close to it.
Yeah, 62%, 57%. Exactly the kind of basketball Bill Self loves, right? He's not happy at all right now. Kansas only 1 of 7 from the free throw line. I don't think they got to the line after about the 10-minute mark.
Somehow, though, the Horned Frogs have got to have some help for Kian Anderson. How about that? He scored 19 of his team's last 21 points in the half.
Yeah, he was tremendous. And, you know, the thing about that is his teammates recognize that as well. Now they had Shepard sitting on the bench, the big center. Had Jarvis Ray sitting on the bench as well. Kansas turned it up here. Defensively got him trapped in the corner.
And a timeout taken by Trent Johnson. So we'll take it with him. Just 5 seconds into the second half, and Trent Johnson said, come on, guys, we got to play with some more intensity. We're back after this from our friends at Phillips 66. So here we go to kickstart the second half once again. 47-40, our score with Chris Piper. I'm Dave Armstrong. So glad to have you courtside with us at Allen Fieldhouse.
Kansas, big pressure to start the second half. Forced TCU into turnover right again.
So even after the timeout, they couldn't figure things out. Tharp tries a three. Ellis clears the glass.
Might have been a little message at halftime from Bill Self about intensity on the defensive end.
Mm-hmm. Tharp able to get inside, and first, Kavar Shepard broke it up, but Ellis stayed with the play. And now the Jayhawks enjoying their biggest lead of the game. A whistle and a foul. This is on Selden. Selden picks up his first, team's first, this half.
Tighter call than we saw in the first half. It really looked like Harris kind of leaned back into Wayne Selden as he's driving.
If you're Trent Johnson, are you concerned at all that it's just right now a Kian Anderson show, or are you okay that at least you're staying in the neighborhood with KU?
Well, you had to have a Kian Anderson show in the first half. You had two of your big men sitting on the bench. Emmer Field spent some time there as well. There's a moving screen.
And that's a foul on Shepard. And here's Kian Anderson in the first half. He had 21 first half points, more than half of his team's points.
Oh, he did it all over the floor. You know, crossover moves coming off ball screens, pull-up jumpers, step-back shots as well. Just effective in finding open looks against that Kansas defense. It just didn't quite have the intensity level I don't think that Bill Self was looking for.
A trap in the corner. Tarik Black. Wiggins. Wiggins had 11 in the first half.
Yeah, only one miss, I think.
Yeah.
Wiggins, 5 of 6.
Selden almost creates another turnover, but last touched by Wayne Selden. It'll stay with the Horned Frogs. Bayhawks, when they have the halftime lead, don't lose. They're 16-0 this year with a half lead. KU has a streak going at home of 111 straight wins against non-ranked opponents.
one of the keys to winning Big 12 championships is winning, number one, games at home and winning the games you're supposed to. You do those two things. Bill Self said you're going to have some losses, but you just got to take care of business.
This foul is on Shepard, who has now picked up number four. So Kavar Shepard, who didn't play much in the first half because of foul trouble, looks like he's going back to the bench.
A great post position established by Tarik Brown early in transition, got him buried. But as a defender in the post, you got to move. You got to move your feet early. You got to play post defense early. Play it late, you get stuck behind. That's when you get into foul trouble.
And only 4 minutes in the first half for Shepard, and now leaving under with just over 2 minutes played here in the second.
Well, the problem with Shepard there was the ball's on one side of the floor. He's on the other side. You got to get between man and ball to start. That would be a benefit to him there, and then he wouldn't put himself in foul trouble. But if you play defense late, that's when you're going to get fouls.
The Jayhawks are just 1 of 8 from the free throw line today.
With Shepard sitting on the bench, if he can stay out.
Yeah. He only played 2 minutes of the first half himself because of two quick fouls.
Thark not helping off of Anderson so far. He shouldn't. He should just stick glued to him.
Big man game with Americk Fields. Here comes Selden.
Jarvis Ray took the brunt of that and got the foul.
That is a foul on Ray, his third.
Yeah, good post position inside again by Tarik Black, driving his man up the lane, establishing that little lob pass. And Jarvis Ray was actually there. He's just there late. It's always the worst is when you get hurt and you get the foul. Get hit.
Lob pass. Oh, my! With Price underneath him. Tarik Black.
Not happy at all calling the timeout. The lob underneath. Look, Perry Ellis driving Americk Fields up the floor. It opens up the lob from the backside. Hudson Price thinks he's there, but no, he's not. He's got Tarik Black going above the rim for the finish. And here you get the bird's eye view of over the top, and Kansas does that so well. And Trent Johnson obviously has talked to his team about it because it happened so many times at TCU, and he immediately calls timeout.
Well, that was a perfect pass from Wiggins. It's exactly where Coach Self teaches guys to throw it on the alley-oop to the corner of the backboard.
Yeah, and throw it high. Let them go get it. Don't throw it low. That's not what a lob pass is. You throw it up there, get it to the side, let them go get it.
Jayhawks now have 24 points in the paint, only 10 for TCU. Boy, oh boy, Selden is really bothering Parrish, and that's a five-second call.
Important time for TCU right now. The wheels are coming off. This is a team that's 0-11 in the Big 12, coming off a 29-point loss to Baylor. No, what is it? It's 23?
Yeah.
I get my math. I'm old.
That's okay.
But this, this is the time right now that you can fall apart for TCU.
Selden. No. Ellis. And he'll go to the line. That's the foul on Ray. Oh, boy, now he's got three fouls. Make it four. Four on Ray.
To give up offensive rebounds, it's almost a sure prescription for a foul. And TCU has struggled on the defensive boards, worst in the league at minus 15. Got Shepard sitting on the bench. They got two of their big guys. They've already lost before the season even started. Devontae, Abrin, and Aaron Durley as well.
Mm-hmm.
Torn ACL. Same trip, I think.
So Ray out with four fouls. Four fouls on Kavar Shepard. And as you mentioned, Chris, a thin bench. And so now Thomas Monago, a walk-on senior, forced into action. TCU hasn't done a thing in this second half except turn it over.
Well, and getting stuck on this sideline hadn't been very good for them either, because they've had one called timeout and two turnovers when they got in.
They've only attempted one shot in the second half. Four bottled up. Now Fields. Different intensity with KU defensively this half.
And they're face guarding Anderson as well. Pretty much whoever's guarding Kean Anderson is just staying right with him, not worried about help side defense. Just face guarding him all around the floor. Once he gets the ball out of his hands, pretty much stay with him. Look, Wayne Selden's not leaving. He doesn't really care where the ball's at as much as where his man's at. Mm-hmm. That's different defense than you normally play. Your weak side help, man and ball, but right now, as good as Kean Anderson was in the first half. But what that does, though, Dave, is opens up opportunities for other guys. Amrick Fields now driving. You have one less help defender out there.
Amrick Fields is one of two at the stripe. Wiggins loses the handle, but he'll go to the line. The foul here on Christian Gore.
Foul call number 13, Christian Gore,
his
first.
I think this is a perfect game to talk about an Andrew Wiggins, in that everybody says, well, he really hasn't done much. And in this game, you say, well, what has Andrew Wiggins done? And you know, at first blush, you'd say, well, he hasn't done much. But really? He's got a dozen points. He hasn't done much? Are you kidding me?
Well, I gotta be honest. I was shocked at halftime when I looked and saw that he had 11 points and was 5 of 6.
Yeah.
You know, he's just efficient. He does things quietly, I think. And I think maybe that's what everybody expected. They expected this human highlight reel. Every time he scored would be this amazing play, which mm-hmm. a large majority of them are anyway.
Right.
But, you know, you get spoiled out of it. Great defender, too.
Look at that. He created that.
And a message sent at halftime by Bill Self, I'm pretty sure. And well received by the Jayhawks. They have been fantastic defensively here this second half so far.
An 11-1 run. Fields, that's way long. Has an air ball. Wiggins saved that pass.
You can throw that pass to Wiggins.
Turned this into his personal playground and a 19-point Jayhawk lead. He's starting to pull away, and some of the guys from the NBA are here with All-Star Weekend. Jeff Withey, great shot blocker, now playing with New Orleans. Nick Collison, tremendous player for the Jayhawks from 99 through 2002, and he's now Kevin Durant's best friend in Oklahoma City. Durant's not bad, huh?
I stay right next to him at all times. Nick Collison's had a great pro career.
Yes, he has.
Fantastic job with him just getting his started. You know, it's amazing. You think we talked about Landon Lucas getting some minutes here, but Jeff Withey's a guy that had to wait his turn for Kansas. I mean, he spent a couple years over there sitting watching Morris Twins. Finally got his time out on the floor and now making some money.
You know, I was thinking what you said about this not a typical Bill Self team in terms of defense. And one of the reasons, perhaps, especially with Joel Embiid out today with those injuries, is one of the things KU has had is that shot blocker, that guy that when everything is funneled toward the middle, that guy that can clean up the post. And with Embiid out, they don't really have that guy right now.
Well, yeah, but when Embiid was in, too, they still weren't the defensive team that I think Bill Self wants. And that's attitude. Not necessarily skill level, it's an attitude, and this team, this half is showing that attitude.
Mm-hmm. But yeah,
they have to show that attitude all the time, and that's, you know, you look at last year's team from Kansas, that team had that attitude. They lost it for a few games, but they got it back and made the deep run. But it's toughness and attitude that Bill Self instills on the defense. worst team is still earning.
First field goal, by the way. There's another lob pass that Selden somehow gets to go home. How did he do that?
Unbelievable athletic play on the backside. And again, TCU getting burned on that play.
Last week, I saw TCU at Iowa State. And time and again, the Cyclones were able to beat him with Melvin Edgem, who had a Big 12 record 48 in that game.
Yeah, that's a lack of communication on the backside, especially when you're in a zone. You got to know what's happening behind you. Swing of the ball. Here comes the middle pick. Take the baseline pick with Perry Ellis. Here comes Wayne Selden sneaking in. It's not a great pass. Mistimed it a little bit. It's still able to get the finish for Selden.
That was such an athletic move by Wayne Selden. He now has 13 points. Wiggins with 50, and the guy leading the way, a guy that I think has not gotten near enough attention all year long, is Perry Ellis. He has 17 today.
Yeah, he's, again, another guy that just scores quietly for you. Consistent.
Anderson flashes in, and he'll go to the line. Foul here is on Ellis.
Perry Ellis is third.
And Anderson's fast. When he gets his motion going, gets turned, gets those shoulders by you, you are not going to stop him one-on-one. Got to get that weak side rotation coming. Kansas late again.
Five team fouls on the Jayhawks this half. That was the third on Perry Ellis. And for Anderson, his first point of the second half. They're scoring 21 in the first. Instantly, and then shoot for $66,000. Phillip 66, proud to be here. Jayhawks comes into focus. Pleased to be with you here. Chris Piper, I'm Dave Armstrong, watching the Jayhawks pull away from TCU. Horned Frogs had a 6-point lead in this game once upon a time, but Wiggins and company have been able to really command the second half.
Lars Sheppard and Jarvis Ray both back on the floor now for TCU. Four fouls.
Ellis was losing the handle and still found Selden. And now Selden with 15. He throws up a rainbow, but it won't go. Trailer.
That's covering a lot of distance with one dribble.
Yeah, it is.
He is so athletic. A latecomer to basketball as well. We talked about Joel Embiid, obviously, so much.
Look at that hustle. Shepard, no. There he is again, Trailer.
Good hands.
This second half is what this Jayhawk faithful have come to see. Kansas playing at another level this half.
quickly driving the basket. Watch a nice pass, the catch. Perry Ellis underneath. And Kansas continues to attack inside, pulling away now, up 25. Scored TCU 23-5 this half and have opened up a 25-point lead, and they've let the genie out of the bottle. Barbara Eden has joined us here at Allen Fieldhouse today, along with her husband, John Eichholz, who is a KU alum, and it's just so good to have Barbara Eden on hand here today in Lawrence. Jarvis Ray comes out of that timeout to score two for the Horned Frogs, and they have hit just two of their last eight shots. Meanwhile, KU has hit their last seven. Wiggins. And a whistle and a foul. This one on Jamari Traylor. Team foul number seven this half. Today's game brought to you by Puerto Rico Tourism Company. Live your own star vacation story. Puerto Rico, the all-star island. Visit seepuertorico.com. So Jarvis Ray will go to the line, a 68% free throw shooter. This is the front end of a 1-1. And he'll get the bonus. So Ray right now playing with four fouls. Tavar Shepherd also playing with four fouls. Threw it into the bench.
Yeah, I got to have better reading that. Good defense by TCU. Kansas has been sending that high ball screen against that 2-3 zone. Trying to initiate a little one-on-one ability to get into the lane.
Only the sixth turnover for KU today.
Had early turnover troubles, too, for Kansas in the first 4 minutes, and they were good after that.
Tipped out of bounds by Ray. It'll go to the Jayhawks, who are wearing these new uniforms. They are, by the way, 6-0 in the new uniforms. They call these chalk, and the away uniforms they call fog. And one of the things they have on this that you really can't see on television are little pinstripes. And in the pinstripes are words, words like pay heed, the game you love began here. Respect those who came before you. Make their legacy your own. Whistle and a foul. And that was on Landon Lucas. First foul on Lucas.
Yeah, we talked about Landon Lucas does a nice job of getting post presence inside, and that time he worked a little too hard for that presence. Mm-hmm. Kavar Shepherd came out of there trying to make sure his neck was still intact.
Anderson did a good job of just hanging onto that ball. They had him trapped in the corner if they'd have been a hair more aggressive. And Shepherd goes strong the hole in his foul.
Joel Embiid sitting over the bench thinking about he'd like to have been in there to try to block that shot. Sitting there with those knee problems that he's had. He actually did that, I think, originally in the TCU game. He looked like he hyperextended a little bit. He's been sitting there, also hurt his back against West Virginia. Has not practiced the entire week. They're hoping to get him back on the practice floor tomorrow, possibly. But obviously, the score of 21 right now, it's been a good chance for Joel Embiid to sit there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you think about that, though, Dave. You talked about Joel Embiid, his only second, third year playing basketball. One of the things that he still has to learn is that
when you get hurt, you are going to get better. And you're also going to be hurt from time to time. And I think for guys that have played basketball a long time, they know they have twisted ankles and they're going to get better from them. It's going to hurt, things like that. And that'll have to be a process for Joel Embiid as well. Get a lot of hits inside.
Harp saved that one to Francamp. Camp for three this time. Here comes Christian Gore. Gore, who transferred to TCU from Brown, is fouled on the play. And the Jayhawks right now sitting at 9-2 in conference play, well on their way to their 10th straight win, which, by the way, would give them 10 or more conference wins for 20 straight years. You talk about consistency, and this could be their 10th straight Big 12 title. Right now they're in the driver's seat. We talked to Bill Self about that.
The driver's seat is probably, I guess that is accurate, but it's kind of a little too strong, really. We had a chance to really put ourselves in the driver's seat if we'd have performed better in Manhattan, and they outplayed us, so that didn't happen. But what we got to do is, you know, obviously you need to hold serve. I mean, you don't have to, but I guess we won the league last year and didn't serve her, or tied for it, hold serve at home. But that you really helped your chances. And then let's go steal one or two. We got three left on the road, and you put yourself in a pretty good position. But the thing about our league is people can get down when you lose a game, but when your league's this good, I mean, good gosh, you're going to lose games. And I don't think you can put too much emphasis on one loss or sometimes even two losses. The bottom line is that when you play good people, especially away from home, you know, a lot of times you get them sad. Now, you don't want to, but it still happens. And certainly we need to be better on the road when we go on it. But the big thing is just try to get better and not let one become two.
Doesn't look like that's going to happen with the Jayhawks leading now by 19. And he's right about the Big 12 being so good. Great wraparound pass. And Ellis will pick up the loose change for his 23rd points. But Selden, tremendous wraparound pass inside. Big 12 has not only the number one RPI in the country as far as the conference is concerned, but how about this, Chris? 9 of the 10 teams in the Big 12 are ranked in the top 71 in the BPI index.
Yeah, conference has been great, and I think it's been a bit of a surprise as well for a lot of people how good some of the teams have become.
And I don't think in this conference we talk enough about if Kansas, and there's still a ways to go, but if they win yet another conference title, 10 straight, now some of those they've shared, but still, that's consistency we haven't seen in this era ever. Now, the UCLA days, yeah, that was another era. It was an unbelievable feat what UCLA was able to pull off. But for the Jayhawks to do this in a power conference, I think is one of the most remarkable things going in college basketball.
Well, the league's been good, too. Yeah. There's been some really good teams in the league. Yeah, consistency. Bill Self has done a tremendous job here. It always starts on the defensive end for him as well.
Ellis, two more.
Wow.
27 for Ellis. He is 12 of 14 in the game.
You know, the difference with this team, I think, than some of Bill's other teams, this one is definitely not as good defensively. No question about that. But this one is also pretty darn good on the offensive end. I mean, there's so many ways for them to score.
Navarre Shepherd steps out. By the way, Perry Ellis with 27 today, Chris. That's a new career high. His previous career high came against Duke early this year when he had 24. Tipped out of bounds, and we've got a timeout. If you come down on Fieldhouse, you must look up into the rafters because that's where all the banners hang. And with Big 12 championships, they've decided to whittle it down to two banners, not one. We're back after this from our friends at Phillips 66. After the Jayhawks are pulled away from TCU. Horned Frogs shooting just 38% in the second half. Check out some of Pike's picks. It's hard to say.
It's hard to say.
Peter Piper. And your first team all Big 12. And this is kind of a... Is this set in stone, or is this something you're going to work on as we go?
Yeah, it's moving. Actually, it's moving right now as we speak. Hey, there's a lot of basketball left to go. DeAndre Kane, though, is a great start to the league. Edgem also did well. But I tell you what, if Kansas ends up at the top of the Big 12, how can you not have two? Gary Ellis being that conversation. Lane Seldon. Yeah. Joel Embiid. I mean, a lot of guys. You look at Oklahoma. They've done Texas. League is good. League is strong. But I'll tell you one thing. I think when we see Marcus Smart come back on the floor, we're going to see a different player out of him. I think he kind of let things get to him, got a little frustrated, wasn't playing his best basketball. When he comes back, I will be shocked not to see him play his best basketball this season, trying to get Oklahoma State rolling again.
Ian Anderson has been held to just 1 second half point after scoring 21 in the first half.
Yeah, he was great in the first half. Kansas guarding him a little differently here in the second half. Get a little more focused defensively as well, team-wise, in the second half for Kansas.
That's amazing. I mean, he looked like he was just going to go lay that up.
Trailer's 4 of 5 in this game. Think he's playing a little more aggression today after having to sit out Monday?
Yeah.
Oh. Seldon with a rebound. He's got 4 of those now to go along with his 15 points. Turnover for KU. 5:18 remaining.
And that's the one place that Kansas has done a really nice job is not giving possessions away here this afternoon. Only 8 turnovers on the afternoon.
Out of bounds by Mason. 13 turnovers for TCU, but the majority of those coming here in the second half. Only had 4 at the break. Saves it. Oh, what a save.
Yeah, when things are going well for you. Seen a couple nice saves there for Kansas. Tad.
All right, Trailer going in there.
Perry Ellis with 30. He's only missed 2 shots all day, and he's hit both of his 3s.
Well, you know, he struggled against TCU the first time these 2 teams played. He did not shoot the ball very well from the floor, but he has been tremendous, and that's all over the floor. The 3 on the outside, and a little bit of a smile. Did we see emotion out of Perry Ellis there as he's running down the floor? Is he 2 for 3 from, or 2 for 2 from 3?
2 for 2.
Yeah, and that's his only 2 threes made in Big 12 play. 30 points. Look at those numbers. 13 of 15. Active on the glass as well.
And believe it or not, he's not one of the guys on the Wendy's wooden walk. You see, DeAndre Kane is part of that as a top 25 candidate. And 2 guys from the Jayhawks are on that list, Andrew Wiggins and Joel Embiid. By the way, Kane had 17 today as Iowa State was able to hold off Texas Tech 70-64. State now 7-5 in league play. Gore. That was partially blocked by White. Andrew White, who hasn't played much, started to play early in the year, Chris, and then got hurt and really hasn't been in the mix since. Now here he is.
Yeah, you know, there's so many guys in that same storyline for Kansas.
Underneath Ellis, took the brunt of it, and also has fouled out of this game. So under 4 to go, and the Jayhawks are rolling. today's Big 12 Network game, brought to you by Phillips 66. Proud to be here. By Wendy's new Ciabatta Bacon Cheeseburger, available at participating Wendy's for a limited time. And by Buick. Visit your local Buick dealer to see why thousands of people are switching to Buick. When you're seeing shots of the Big Dipper, as really Lawrence, Kansas became Hollywood last night with the debut of the movie The Jayhawkers. And that movie, by the way, is a lot about Wilt Chamberlain, about that era of Jayhawk basketball, and it stars this guy. Justin Wesley played Wilt Chamberlain in the movie. And according to Coach Self, who took the entire team last night to this, he said, Wesley wasn't just good in the role, he was great. Can't wait to see it. Wesley's going to get a chance to play.
Bill's kind of a hard critic, too, so.
He must have. Really like it.
Ellis comes out. Wesley comes in. Ellis, by the way, with a brand new career high of 32 points. What a game.
Yeah, he was tremendous. I mean, he was aggressive, looking at the basket, finding openings in that zone.
13 of 15, and on one of those misses, if I'm...
He got his own back and
made it. So, talk about efficient. Wow. This is where TCU just got stuck again. Didn't really run their offense. They only have 18 points this half. Kamari Traylor now has a new career high. He has 10 points in this game.
Well, you touched on it, Dave, and I think we didn't kind of forgot to talk about it, but he did not play against Kansas State. Sat out that game, coach's decision, and he has been tremendous here.
And that's a travel. Anderson trying to walk the tightrope at half court. Kamari Traylor, by the way, with a new career high coming off the bench today. He is our sixth man of the game, brought to you by Motel 6.
Yeah, great effort, great energy off the bench for Kansas. I mean, he was so strong inside that play where he dove out of bounds for a loose ball. And that's what Kamari Traylor has to bring for Kansas, that energy, effort, toughness inside.
So many guys, it's hard to get playing time for everyone. Boy, good move there by Kian Anderson.
That's one of the few times he's got open here in the second half.
His first field goal of the second half. Tarik Black will go to the line. This game well in hand. The only drama now will KU crack the 100 mark. At 91 right now. Black in this game, 5 points.
Line,
Tarik, three from the line.
Now Tarik Black is another guy with, when Joel Embiid was healthy, he wasn't getting as much time. He's gotten foul trouble early in the season and just twisted ankle just a couple of games. Just the TCU game. Makes practices competitive for Kansas. When you got guys that all want minutes, Landon Lucas, Andrew White, Tarik Black, Frank Mason, Connor Framham, all those guys want minutes. You got a battle in practice to keep your spot.
Nico Roberts, Evan Manning have already checked in. Christian Garrett will be the next guy to come in for Tarik Black if he makes his free throw, which he does. All the walk-ons are now playing for KU. Garrett, by the way, is still looking for his very first point in a Jayhawk uniform. Evan Manning able to pick the pocket. Nico Roberts throws up the hook. Christian Garrett had an opportunity perhaps, but threw it away.
unfortunately for Trent Johnson, he doesn't really have any other guys he can put on the floor.
Yeah, right.
So shorthanded. He's got two guys fouled out. Was able to get Kian Anderson, though, to sit down.
And Anderson winds up with 25 points, 21 of those coming in that first half. White doesn't settle for the jumper. Overall. Meanwhile, the Horned Frogs will drop their 12th straight in conference play.
Scout team out here working hard for Kansas, getting out of passing lanes. That's one steal for Evan Manning and almost another by Nico Roberts.
There's Evan Manning, the son of Danny Manning. Nico Roberts, the son of assistant coach Norm Roberts. And Tyler Self has been out with an injury all year.
Yeah, he's had surgery on his foot, actually.
Monago will go to the line. Allaire was on Nico Roberts.
Now tough test coming up for Kansas Tuesday in Lubbock against Texas Tech, a place that Kansas has had its troubles.
That
Texas
be
Tech
right
playing
here.
Good basketball.
Chris, that'll be right here on the Big 12 Network. I'll be there courtside in Lubbock along with Reed Geddes. Join us for that broadcast Tuesday night.
And those are the type of games that Kansas has to win. A lot of games left, though. You're looking throughout all the schedules, Texas, the games that they have remaining, Kansas State, Iowa State.
White, no.
He's going to come
over the back, Garrett. Well, you look at the schedule for the Jayhawks, and you're right, big road game. I mean, Texas Tech is playing so much better. They lost today by only 6 at Iowa State at Hilton Coliseum, and they had won 3 in a row prior to that. And then, of course, the big matchup with Texas was one game behind KU in the standings.
Well, at Oklahoma State on that, and then, you know, West Virginia, they play Kansas tough here. Got to go at West Virginia, who just dismantled Iowa State there earlier this week.
In case you're just joining us, Oklahoma beat Oklahoma State to sweep the Bedlam series this year. They won 77-74 today. Iowa State beat Tech. Tonight it's Kansas State at Baylor at 6 o'clock and West Virginia at Texas at 7.
Sticking his nose in there. Had a great game against Kansas down in Fort Worth, 11 points. Another game that TCU in foul trouble.
Christian Gore, transfer from Brown University.
TCU's got some guys coming back next year from injuries, some guys coming back from transfer. Chris Washburn.
Yes.
Chris Washburn's son was the largest man I've ever been hit by in my life.
Really?
When he played for North Carolina State. I think he broke me in half.
You haven't recovered yet.
No.
Well, that'll be the ball game as the Jayhawks win it by 30, 95-65 on a career day for Perry Ellis with 32 points today. And the Jayhawks go to 10-2 in league play. So that's the story from Lawrence as we get you to Doug Bell in Studio 66.